This is the YGTV News.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Wednesday, the 17th of April. I'm Vanessa Garcia. RGP requests for information over child abduction. Further arrest on fraud charges. Chief Minister and press in London for Thatcher funeral. Funeral arrangements for the late Charles Bruzon. And finally, dress in orange for MS Day. Officers of the Royal Gibraltar Police Safeguarding Unit investigating an allegation of child abduction by a parent are keen to establish the whereabouts of Verena Borge, 36 years of age, and her 5-year-old son, Berlin Frokowski. It is understood that Verena may be driving a Mercedes-Benz estate registered in the United Kingdom. The last known sighting of both Verena and Merlin was in Gibraltar on Thursday, the 4th of April. Any information on the whereabouts of both individuals should be directed to the Royal Gibraltar Police on telephone number 200 72 500. Further to the arrest and charge of a 45-year-old woman on suspicion of fraud, officers of the Serious Crime Unit on Tuesday, the 16th of April, arrested 48-year-old Paul Andrew Warrender, a British national and self-employed investment manager, on suspicion of fraud. Together with a 45-year-old woman, Warrender is alleged to have falsely represented that they were entitled to rent out a property. Warrender has been charged with one count of fraud by false representation and 5 counts of fraud by failing to disclose information. He will be appearing at the Magistrates' Court at 10 a.m. the 17th of April. The Chief Minister has been in London today to attend the funeral of Baroness Thatcher this morning. Members of the local press have been invited along the trip. And speaking to the YGTV, Londoner Julia Simkis noted that she had travelled from Hampstead to watch the procession. Julia carried a red rose with her, which she planned to lay at St Paul's Cathedral. She was a fantastic Prime Minister until towards the end, Julia explained. She was in the office for too long. This evening, the Chief Minister will address members of the prestigious Fabian Society on Gibraltar in Europe. The public is advised that the funeral for late Charles Bruzon will take place tomorrow, Thursday, the 18th of April. The hearse carrying his coffin will depart the Cathedral of St. Mary the Crowned at 1540, make its way along Linewall Road and turn into John McIntosh Square. It will stop briefly at the City Hall, where Minister Bruzon headed the Ministry of Housing. Staff there will pay their respects and follow the hearse as it makes its way slowly round the square to arrive in front of Parliament Building. The family of the late minister will meet and follow the hearse, as will the Chief Minister and Mrs. Bigardo, the Speaker and Mrs. Canepa, and the Deputy Chief Minister and Mrs. Garcia. All government ministers, the mayor, members of opposition and former parliamentarians will also pay their respects and join the procession to the cathedral. The funeral service is scheduled to start at 4 p.m. At the conclusion of the service, the funeral cortege will leave the cathedral and make its way to North Front Cemetery, where Charles Bruzon will be laid to rest. The family have requested no wreaths but for a donation to be made to the Gibraltar Society for Cancer Relief. And finally, on Tuesday the 30th of April, the Gibraltar MS Society are holding a dress in orange for MS Day to mark both MS Awareness Week and our official launch of the Society. They would appreciate it if schools, places of work, groups, anyone who would like to join in and raise some awareness to join in by wearing something orange that day. If you wish to take part as a company, school, group or individual, please let them know by emailing gibraltararms@yahoo.co.uk. That's the YGTV News. We're back tomorrow. See you then.